Here is a first look at our lobster boat redesign. We can rotate this so you can see what we're going to do. This is our design rendering, so some things are not quite 100% locked in, but you can see a general idea of the concept. So we're keeping the hull largely as it was in our original lobster boat, the semi-dory design. So this bow, it cuts through the water really nicely. It also has a little bit of rocker very subtly down on the bottom so that it'll get up on plane. And you can look around to the transom. So we have as a placeholder here, this is where the rudder lives when it is in a sailing mode. The rudder would come off, and at the center here, you would put your larger planing motor. Now, one of the most common questions that we've been asked is whether you can leave the motor on while you're sailing. Because the primary motor is a planing motor, it has to be centered, and the rudder also has to be centered. That means that you're using that same piece of real estate for both, so you need to take the rudder off if you're going to be putting on your planing motor. That said, you can use an offset motor bracket that would set to one side. A smaller auxiliary kind of motor, like if you want a little have a little two-horse trolling motor or something like that, or a little electric, we can put an offset motor bracket here to one side. That way you'll be able to still have your motor as backup power. The only thing is that isn't your planing motor. So continuing our little tour here, the interior is largely for position only. This is to make sure that we could do our flotation calculations for the US Coast Guard, that we could have this boat rated for a 10 horsepower motor. So this is that outer flotation tanks. Those are all to spec for that 10 horsepower motor. The cross seats here, these are kind of up for debate. Once we actually have the mold built, then that's going to be one of the last things that we do is determine the exact positioning of those seats. This stern one is probably going to be movable or adjustable in some way. Not a full-on sliding seat, but at least you can have a couple positions or even take it out entirely. And the forward seat here is definitely going to have some more structure in it, particularly for the balance lug option, because that's an unstayed mast. So we're going to need to make sure that that has some good structure built in, which you don't see here in the model. But you can see we've added this nice round kind of slipper shape to the deck. Previously, it came a little bit further back and went straight across, but that made it a little bit hard to get your passengers or your weight far enough forward to really get the boat to trim properly when you're planing. So we also wanted to make it easier to step into the boat from the beach, because one of the best features about this boat is that it's so easy to beach. You can drop your crab pot, zoom over to the beach, jump out, do some clamming. So it's really, really important to us that this be a boat that you can easily get into from the beach. So having the deck that curve a little bit further forward is going to make it easier to step in from shore. So that's pretty much a preview of the major changes that we're making. And I'm also going to just preview what it looks like with the sail rig on. So this boat is going to have the standard sail. Is going to be a balanced lug rig as shown here. So similar to what you find on our Melon Seed, our Salish Voyager, and the Scamp. So this is just a concept drawing with the balanced lug rig. We are going to have an option of an upgrade to a sloop, so main and jib, which is what we had on the original lobster boat. So we've got a couple different options there. If you are maybe a little bit newer to sailing, or you're thinking that you're primarily wanting to motor, the balanced lug could be a great option for you. If you're really into sailing, you want to be able to have some more versatility with the two sails, the main and the sloop, get a little bit closer to the wind, then you have that option available as well. So there she is. This is our concept redesign of the new lobster boat. So we've got another probably couple months ahead of us until we have that prototype available to view, but wanted to give you guys a look at the exciting new design that's coming out.